Hey guys, so we're going to be making this little pumpkin pin today. I'm filming this on my phone, so hopefully it'll be okay, but yeah, it's just attached by a safety pin on the back. It looks really cute on scarves or whatever you want to put it on, really. So let's get started. Things you're going to need, I'm using a 2.5mm crochet hook, and you're going to need some yarn. I'm using a DK. You could use a thicker yarn, but you're going to lose some of the detail in the pumpkin, so I think a thinner one for this is probably better, but you can use whatever colour you wanted. Some people do really nice white pumpkins, but I wanted to use a little classic dirty orange colour. Yep, let's go. Okay, so we're going to start by making a magic ring. I'll show you how to do this. Let me take my gloves off, hang on, so you can see what I'm doing. So, let's do a magic ring. Pop the working end of the yarn over your finger. Wrap it round and over to form a cross. Pop your hook under the first loop. Pick up the second, pull it through, and then I like to do a single crochet on the top of there as well, just to keep it nice and secure. If you do struggle with the magic ring, there are lots of tutorials on YouTube as well. Okay, so now we're going to start with doing 6 single crochets into the magic ring. It will be a double crochet if you do UK terms, single US terms. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you can stitch this circle in, just pull it in. That's the first round done. Second round, we're going to be increasing in each stitch. So we'll have 12 stitches at the end of the round. So single crochet, 1, 2 for the increase, 3, 4 for the increase, 5, 6 for the increase, 7, 8 for the increase, 9, 10 for the increase, 11, and one more, 12, and that's the increase. So now you can check whether it's all correct. You can go and count around your stitches. If you see these little, if I zoom in, if you can see these little V's, so maybe point with something. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you should have 12 of those little V's for your second round. Right, on to round 3. So we're going to be increasing in multiples of 3 now. So at the end of this round we will have 18 stitches. So the pattern is single crochet, increase, single crochet, increase, all the way around. But the easy way to do this is actually just increase on the multiple of 3. So I'll show you what I mean. So 1, 2, 3 to increase, because that's a multiple of 3. 4, 5, increase on 6, because that's the multiple of 3. 7, 8, increase for 9. 10, 11, increase for 12. 13, 14, whoops, increase increase for 15. 16. 17. And increase for 18. So now if you count all the stitches around, there should be 18 stitches altogether. Do that and then come back to the video. So you have 18 stitches around now, and now we're going to increase again, and we're going to increase on every multiple of 4. So I'll do it with you. 1, 2, 3, increase 4, 5, 6, 7, increase for 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that was an increase, 30, 14, 15, increase for 16. Increase for 20. 21, 22, 23, and increase for 24. So now you should have 24 stitches all the way around. Do that and then come back to the video. For this next round, we aren't going to be increasing anymore. That's the end of the increasing. We're just going to be going round and round and round for a few rounds. I usually do this by eye until I think it looks tall enough, but I think it's about 6 or 7 rounds, and I'll let you know in a second. For now, pop your if you want to use a stitch marker, or if you, I usually just use the yarn that's left over from the magic ring, pop it in there so I know where I started. And I just single crochet around, we'll say for about 7 rounds for now. But listen in the video for when I actually stop. So keep going all the way around, and I'll let you know in a second how many rows I do. Okay, so yeah, I was right on the 7 rounds of single crochet. So just to show you that I've done 7 rounds, you can count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rounds. You always want to make sure you count to the left side of this knot. If you've got your stitch marker, because if you count up here, it'll be the wrong count. So now we can start decreasing, and decreasing is pretty much the same as increasing in that you can use the multiples to help you count, so that you don't have to keep using a stitch marker, or so that you don't have to keep using a stitch marker and things like that. So I'm going to show you how to do it. So you should have 24 stitches still, and we're going to now decrease that to 18. So we're still going to decrease on every multiple of 4. I'm going to show you how to do that. So single crochet 1, 2, and now to decrease, I'm going to pick up this front loop of the next stitch and the front loop of the stitch after that, and that's stitch 3 and 4. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through to decrease. So you've done single crochet 1, 2, and 3 and 4 with a decrease. 5, 6, and again 7, 8 is your decrease. 9, 10. 11, 12 is the decrease. 13, 14, 15, 16 is the decrease. 17, 18, 19, 20 is the decrease. 21, 22, and 23, and 24 is your decrease. So now you will have 18 stitches around, so if you want to count that. You can also pull out your stitch marker. And we're going to put some stuffing in now. So pull out your loop a bit so that you don't lose your space. And we're going to insert some stuffing. Grab your toy stuffing. And you can stuff this as firm as you want. I think that it tends to work better when it's quite firm. Because the next step you're going to actually be like pulling the yarn around to make the pumpkin shape. So I do think it's better it being quite firm. So you can really shove it in there and move it around. After the next step as well, we're going to decrease again. You can like top it up a little bit, which is what I'm going to do now. So grab your hook, cinch that in again. So we've just decreased on every multiple of 4, and now we're going to decrease on every multiple of 3. So 1, decrease, 2, 3, 4, decrease, 5, 6, 7, decrease, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, decrease, 13, 14, 15 to decrease, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so now you'll have 12 stitches around. You can count that. I'm going to stuff mine a little bit more. Use the end of your crochet hook to pack it in there. Like I said, I think it's better to be quite firm. Oh, excuse me, a hiccup. It's better to be quite firm. That should be fine. So you've got this ball shape. it won't be a ball shape for long though. So now we have 12, we're going to decrease one more time. So pop your hook in. So this time we're going to decrease on every stitch up to 12. And we can count to 12 so we know how many we've done. So 1, 2. 10. One more time. It's going to be fiddly. 11. 12. Okay. We've got a tiny little hole there left, but we are going to sort that out in a second. So now you want to cut your yarn. You want to leave quite a bit here. because you're going to be using this to make the pumpkin shape. So I'd maybe leave about 16 inches maybe. That's just a guess, but so I'm going to cut a nice long tail. Pull my yarn through so it's not coming undone now. You want to grab a yarn needle. Right, got myself a darning needle, my pumpkin, and a nice long bit of yarn that I've just tied a knot in. It's fine, let's just put it nice and tight. Right, so thread your needle up. And we're going to close this hole now. Okay, so as you can see the little outer loops. So we're just going to close it up. So just pick up the outer loop of the next stitch. Whoa! Of the next stitch and pull through. And what this is going to do is going to slowly tie it. So the next stitch. And just keep moving around, picking up the outer stitch of the remaining stitches. This is just going to close it nice and neatly. It doesn't need to be too neat because this bit's actually going to get concaved in to make the shape anyway. I'm just going to do one more. Okay, there we go. Right, now comes the exciting part. We're going to make the shape of the pumpkin. So what you're going to do is you're going to thread your yarn straight through the centre of the pumpkin. And pull through. Okay, so now you can pull it in and you can like concave the top. You're going to bring the yarn around the edge of the pumpkin and thread it back through the middle. It doesn't matter if it's not forming a shape right now because you're going to push it through the center and pull through again. And now you can see it's around the edge. So now you can pull as tight as you want to make that pumpkin shape. So I like doing it quite tight because I like them quite shapy. And now you're going to bring the yarn up again and over to the side of it and thread it through the middle. So it can get a bit tricky because it gets quite tight in there. Through the middle, yeah. Pull it through the middle again. Somehow managed to tighten a knot. There we go. Place it where you want it. So I want it over to the side a little bit, like that. And pull nice and tight to make the indent. You're just going to carry on like that. So then around to the side a bit, down through the middle, pull it, and tight. Over a little bit more. Push it through the middle, pull tight, make the pumpkin shape, and just keep going until you've got as many little concavey bits as you want. I'm going to do maybe two more, so down through the middle, and one more. Nice and tight. So now you can see, got a nice bobbly shaped pumpkin. So you want to sort of fasten this now, so that last one doesn't go all saggy. So if you want to pull it, hold it nice and tight with your finger, go in through the bottom and out through the side, and just give that a nice pull. And then that just makes it nice and tight. And you can always weave in the ends a little bit. I like to go through the work, pull it through the work again. So I'm going in and out of the same hole. It's just, it's like matting around the stuff in the middle so that it's making it nice and tight. I do one more. Now I'm going to use this excess yarn that I've got to actually tie around the safety pin after we finish everything else. So I'm just going to bring it out through the bottom, pull off it off my darning needle, and then that's done for now. You can always squidge it into a shape that you prefer, like I'm like making them a bit taller, but they're very cute. So now all we've got to do is, if I get my run that I've done, we've got to do the little stalk and some curly leaves. So we're going to do the stalk next. So grab your crochet hook and some brown yarn. So I have my brown yarn, my same size crochet hook, and we're going to start off with a magic ring again. So just to go over that one more time, hold the working yarn going over and off your hand, wrap it round, over and across, pick up the back loop underneath the first loop, and then slip stitch to secure it, and that's that. Now this is really, really easy. All we're going to be doing is 6 single crochets and then another 6 single crochets on top of that to make the stalk. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cinch that in. And then, like I said, really easy, another 6 on top of those 6. So no increasing or anything here, just another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, to get this back in shape, to get this back in the shape that we want, if you grab your end of your crochet hook, you can sort of like push it out into a better shape. See, that looks a lot better now. So, just to secure that, do a little slip stitch into the next stitch along. Leave. You're going to sew this in, so leave a good amount of yarn. Pull it through. You've got this little end that, just make sure it's nice and tight, and then snip that sort of there. And we are focus. And we're just going to use the end of my crochet hook just to push that end in. Pads out a little bit as well. Okay, so now you've got your little stalk. So you're going to grab your pumpkin, grab a darning needle, thread up your stalk, and pop it on the top. So we're going to sew this in. So I like to just go through the side of the stalk like that, and then out through the side of the pumpkin, through a little gap in the pumpkin, and pull that nice and tight. Go back through the same gap and up through the side again, and up through stalk, side of the stalk. What this is going to do is it's going to sort of wrap around the stuffing and make it nice and tight. So down through, I think I'll go through here, down through another side of the stalk, come out the side of the pumpkin, nice and tight.
Something hard like this. Yeah.
Up through side of the stalk. And just one more time. Down. That feels loose. Yeah, there. So down through. Pumpkin. Gets a bit tight. There we go. Perfect. Now I'm just going to weave the ends through the pumpkin. So just through the sides a few times. Always remember to go in through the same hole you came out as, or you'll be able to see the yarn. Okay, looks good to me. So, snip the yarn, push that a little bit in, you can't see it. And now we've got our little pumpkin with a stalk. It's very cute. Nope. We've got one more step. We're going to do the leaves, and then just to put the safety pin on the back, and then we're done. So for the leaves, grab any like spare green DK yarn and the same hook you've been using. Really just any leftovers for this is fine. You're only going to be using a small amount. So for this we are doing a slip knot. There are many ways to do that, but do whichever way you prefer. Okay, now we're going to chain 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, make the leaves curly. We're going to do 2 single crochets in the next chain from the hook. So, 1, 2. And then 1 single crochet in the next one, 2 in the next one, 1 in the next one, 2 in the next one, and just carry on like that. This is going to make your yarn sort of do a little curl, which I think looks really cute. So do that all the way to the end. As you can see, it's made in like it's a really cute curl. Now, still attached to this curl, I'm going to make a little curl next to it. So chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're going to do the same thing. So, in the next chain from the hook, 2 single crochet, the next just a single, and then 2 single crochet, and the next single, and 2 single crochet. So now we have our leaves, do a slip stitch to fasten off and cut a long enough piece so that we can sew this on. So grab your darning needle and your leaves and your pumpkin, thread that up, place the leaves however you want. You might want them curling outwards, or if you want maybe curling inwards, it's, you know, it's totally up to you. I think I like them curling. I don't know actually. Maybe like that. Yes. So place through the base your needle, and like you did with the stalk, just in through the middle and out through somewhere in the bottom. Pull that nice and tight, because it will pull it like really close in knit near the stalk. So back out through the hole that you've just been into and up through near the leaves again. Make sure you don't catch anything. And grab this side now, I think. And down through the pumpkin. And out. I think I'm gonna do that one more time. So up and up here. Now through the top. And catch this side, I think. And out through the pumpkin. See, it really pulls it nice and tight into the stalk. Just weave this through the rest of the pumpkin just to secure it. Up, up. Like so.
Have you heard of the phone called Pixel?
No. Okay. Snip your yarn. Push the remainder of that yarn in. Now you just want to get rid of this little piece. So I'm just going to put my yarn needle in ready. Hook that in. Oops. Like that. And then pull it through. And nice and tight. And I'm just going to trim that a little bit off. And push that in. Cool. So, now we've done the main part of our pumpkin. And it looks so cute. Now we just need to add the safety pin on the back. I'll show you how to do that. That's super easy. So, grab a safety pin. So I got this pack of safety, different size safety pins. Oh, and I've just lost some. You can use whichever size you want. You could use one of these big giant ones if you wanted. I quite like the size down. Oh my gosh, I'm dropping these everywhere. I quite like this size. Oh my gosh. I'll get those later. So I quite like this size. I think this is the size I used for this. Yes, it is. So that's what we're gonna do. So get your safety pin, get your pumpkin and the yarn. And thread your tail that we made earlier. So work out which side opens, so it's this one. So we're going to be sewing the other side of the safety pin. how you want this to sit when it's like on a coat or whatever. I quite like it with this hanging down to the side. So I will be sewing it like this on at this angle. So that when it's on, yes, like this. So sew it on. All you're gonna do, feed the yarn through the middle of the safety pin and then through, grab up like a loop of your pumpkin at the bottom and pull through. Oops. Like that. It's just hooked on there. There we go. So you're just going to keep doing that. So through the safety pin, through the pumpkin, you're just sewing the safety pin to the pumpkin basically. And that's it guys, once you've done that, tie a little knot, weave it through your pumpkin like usual, and that's it, you've got your really cute little pumpkin pin. Make really cute gifts, so you can put it on your scarf. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And please subscribe and like this video. And hopefully my next project's gonna be some dragon gloves, which everyone really likes at the moment, which I think you saw me wearing at the start. So yeah, see you all soon, guys.